Hello and welcome back to the March of the Super Robots presentation of Super Robot Tyson A Portable. The last time I remember, we've gone so far as to say we're nearly done with this. And by the time you see this, it'll be sometime in April. And I'll possibly be moving on to something else. Anyway. Things we've gone through with these pilots. For some reason, I feel better about this already. I don't think I'm going to be training any pilots anytime too soon, so, let's move out to episode 36. We started La Vienne et Rose. In other words, the colonies are mostly under Haman's control?
Yes. There's almost nobody that's publicly opposing Neo's Young. It's only a matter of time before the moon falls under her control as well.
Oh, brave warriors of practice, Captain Min. Don't you die out there! Oh, by the way, we did get, Fabian Mafu and Mayo, and I did manage to upgrade his unit and weaponry as well. Off camera, of course.
How is it that we never got wind of Haman Khan's, of Neo Zeon's intentions?
Yeah, the Federation rules over space from the planet, and its baselines are opposed to this. It was the general public itself that prevented the success of investigations into the matter.
While we were working hard to form a peace alliance between us and the rest of the people of space, our fellow Earthlings are fighting among themselves.
Just like real life.
Some example research.
I wholeheartedly agree.
We won't get anywhere just by thinking about it.
To be honest, I don't know much about Haman Khan.
You're from a different timeline. Different timeline. You wouldn't know.
Maybe you should ask Akito.
Me?
You're a cook. Surely you would know about Haman Khan. And soon we stop it. Just stop.
Izumi with the Jones.
To put it simply, she's Zeon's regent.
After the 1 year war, there was only one survivor of the Zabi family. The daughter of Dolzel Zabi, Mineva. As such, she's officially the leader of the Principality of Zeon.
However, due to her young age, she's not fit to rule yet.
So her region takes care of all the political matters. Guess it would be more accurate to say that the region holds all of the real power.
Just like real life!
From what you're saying, it seems to me that the relationship between Mineva and Haman is pretty much the same as the one between Marimaya and Dickeen Barton.
It's even worse in Mineva's case.
Marimaya was somewhat aware of what was happening around her, but Mineva has no idea. She lives in her own little bubble. Haman makes sure of that.
You seem to know a lot about this.
It's just something I learned.
Haman's a very scary person, to say the least.
You can say that again. She has that certain something that really draws you to her.
Is this what Zeon's big reform of humanity is all about? Parading a specific bloodline to show how much better they are than everybody else?
That's pretty much what Zeon's about, yeah.
No, that wasn't it. The Principality of Zeon stood for the independence of all those who left Earth to live in space, for the innovation of mankind. It was the Zabbies who warped the original message, turning it into a declaration of war. Of superiority. It was the Zabbies who warped the original message, turning it into a declaration of superiority of the space lines over the Earth lines.
Yes. Very low up here.
I can see why you have trouble, Captain. It's a very deep and complicated subject. There are many schools of thought about humanity's life in space. According to Sidon, the ideology of the inhabitants of the sides, those who have left Earth should be self-governed and self-sufficient. While Juggernauts may seem to follow the same ideals at first, they're actually followers of Aerism, which states that our home planet Earth is sacred and must be preserved at all costs, even if it meant it to live in space.
I had to take a moment there.
I'm going a bit too much.
Zeon Zoom Dekun decided that both ideologies had their pros and cons. For that reason, he mixed them together into a new one called Tumptilism, which states that it is humanity's...
Stop it! I can't remember it all that!
You did that on purpose, didn't you? The only thing I got is that people are still fighting over who's got the best ancestors.
Almost sounds like Japan, doesn't it?
It's not just here. The Bazonians believe that having horns on their head is a sign of superiority. And the Bahamians we fought claim to be the best race in the universe.
Tigano's plan was to judge humanity one by one, purging those who were deemed inferior. In other words, the place or the names may change, but the underlying problem is the same.
Basically, everyone thinks they're special, that everyone else isn't. It's kind of dumb when you put it that way.
I got words for that.
That Federation is no different.
They think their Earthnoids are better than Spacenoids. I've never used the word, but now that I think of that, I am an Earthnoid, huh?
Maybe you could be our representative to show everyone that Earthnoids are not superior.
Representative, huh? That doesn't sound so bad.
Hey, wait!
At any rate, that way of thinking that has caused so many wars. Unless Earth Federation changes, no peace will stick. I'll have a new war in no time.
I'm aware of that. However, we cannot begin this change unless we put an end to this war.
You are on the Rakaru in a mobile suit hangar.
Hey, Asanage! What you doing to my Double Zeta?
Remember that little thing about, for Judo to get an upgrade, he had to make sure he had 5 in the very first mission. We got introed in with him, Amru. Guess what?
Nina brought some supplies, and I found something that you could use. The full armor parts for your mobile suit.
So now you have full armor Double Zeta.
That sounds nice, but it's gonna be okay. I wouldn't want my Double Zeta to be so beefy that it would hardly move.
There'll be a drop of mobility, but it's well compensated by the increased energy efficiency.
You should check it out, I think it's worth it.
And there's his mind. Full armor, double Zeta.
Commander, I have returned. I read your report. Seems there have been changes in the Jovian Federation's movements.
Yes, negotiation broke down and they seem intent in resuming their attacks against Earth. However,
that detachment of Mondo Bell, spearheaded by the Mobile Ship Nanashikla's interference.
Yes, the voice of those who fear drawn out conflict has gained strength, even more so after finding out that little bomb has agreed to ceasefire with the Air Federation.
So they're starting to think that peace may be the better alternative than difficult war.
That's not all. It seems that there has been a coup within the Jovian Federation.
Coups?
Yes, I believe it was staged by a faction sympathetic to Mondo Bell's cause.
Alright, we get it. Let's just give up on those Jovians and move on.
Should have said we had a pause. I had not foreseen the Meganoid's interference.
Not to mention how Nashika made their way out. By removing the Bolson jump control unit from inside the rooms and shooting it out randomly in space. They want to have a great commander leading them.
A great commander? Or a complete moron? I guess we'll find out soon. Meanwhile, on the Nashika.
Please blow your nose, Captain. Maybe someone's talking about me. Well, that's just a superstition. Anyway, Grips 2. That's where the colony laser is, right?
Due to Neo-Zeon and Shuttle Marrow, the E2F has not been able to recover its military police. The destructive power of the Polymi laser should be able to rebalance the situation.
Zeon has tried to overtake it multiple times. Even if we turn back now, the E2F would give us the order sooner or later. They can forget about reinforcements. It's just me, or is it always us we get to do all the work?
Maybe it's because we agree to any order no matter how crazy.
Feeling bitter today, Akatsuki? You have to admit, we are mostly composed of foolish, reckless people.
I've seen party anime. Yes, they are.
Just like a certain captain. Anyway, this is probably going to be the biggest meme-ish battle the Earth Sphere has ever seen. Everyone, this is critical time. Focus your thoughts on the battle and give it your all. That was unusually serious. Ah, of course I'm serious! My lovey-dovey future with Akito is online! Right, Akito?
Idiot.
Maybe you should focus on the battle, Yurika!
I'm pretty sure after this Let's Play is done, I'm gonna be spending a lot of time watching my mecha anime. Just like I've been watching Cobra the Animation. Meanwhile, over on Axis.
I hope you can forgive me, Lieutenant Colonel Annabelle Gato.
Lieutenant Commander.
I hope you can forgive me, Lieutenant Commander Annabelle Gato.
There's nothing to be forgiven, though. This is all for the sake of Zeon.
You don't need to hold back.
Londo Bell's absence would have made for the perfect opportunity to strike. It's only natural that you would not agree with my order standby.
I would never disagree with an order. However, it's his shadow mirror that worries me. I cannot understand their motives. They are dangerous allies.
Well, it's true that I was not able to find out their backup. It's thanks to their information that we were able to outwit London and easily gain control over all the commons.
Even so,
I know that man, Vinder, he reeks of danger. There's something about him, but it was ambition that seems to be something else. In any case, I'll not be a pawn in his game.
I'm glad to hear that. But why have you requested my presence, Mom?
Lando Bell has returned to Epsfield.
Then the time is near.
Yes, this battle is a side effort.
I am well aware of Lando Bell's might. But we have an overwhelming advantage this time.
That was the case during the last war, and yet they managed to completely turn the tide.
You mean when they obliterated the Titan's fleet in a single strike with the colony laser?
Indeed. That's why we must head to Grips 2. We must not forget that the captain of the Rakan took part in Operation Mouser.
Very well. If you'll excuse me, I shall depart. And speaking of the Rakan,
we are approaching Grips 2.
Any signs of the enemy?
The presence of a large number of Xeon mobile suits have been confirmed. Due to Minovsky particle scattering, we cannot calculate a precise number.
Numbers won't matter. This time, victory depends on speed.
You're right. However, their formation seems over.
I see what you mean. Shadowmare must have warned them about our plans. And yet, there they are, preparing a frontal assault, as if they weren't expecting us. It does seem somewhat unnatural. It must be a trap, but we've no choice but to walk straight into it. Episode 36, Those Who Face Their Destiny.
Bell.
They're going for Crips too.
Let's crush them. Wait, Mage. Half of the team will head to Crips too. Worst case scenario, we destroy them. Lionel Bell must not get their hands on them.
All units deployed.
Hell yeah, that's what we're talking about. We got to sit down. Y'all is foo.
I remember dealing with that mess in Gundam Breaker.
Oh,
you don't ever want to touch that bad boy on Gundam Breaker. No, it wasn't Gundam Breaker. Gundam Versus. You don't want to touch that. That is just a batch of no. Gundam Breaker, I could probably deal with that. But, oh, no. Gundam Versus? Oh, no. Well, it's a Gundam match.
Mm-hmm.
So most of what I'm going to use this time around. It's from UC. UC engine. It has to be UC engine. Yeah, I'm basically using Real Robot this time around. Well, done work. The enemy seems to have split into two groups. One for the colony, and one coming to attack us. We won't be able to approach Crypt 2 if they block our way. We'll just have to rush ahead as fast as we can. There's no other way. The enemy must not reach Crypt 2!
We're forced to spend the E2Fs to be here in a while. We have to manage on our own until they do. How long is that while exactly? No idea!
Oh, come on!
Jeez, can't you look into the stuff before it comes up? Rui, got any idea?
Our reinforcements are currently engaged in battle. While they have the advantage, it will take time before they are able to make their way here. ETA is 20 minutes.
That's not good. Xeon will reach Grips way before that. We have to do this ourselves.
Feed all enemy forces while guarding Grips too, huh?
They're using outdated lines. We should be able to match.
How long will we be able to hold them off on our own tank, Commander?
Who's our reinforcements fighting? More Xeon forces?
Unknown. As this is a battle situation, Minovsky particle density is extremely high. However, I have a feeling it is not Xeon they're facing.
These are all from members of the Demas. I don't see him. So, we're gonna play the smart way. Thank you. We have to do the following, which is... For the most part, we have to make a wall. Gotta take into account as much of the range that they have versus ours. And we're ready. They're gonna try to get close. And as soon as they do, we'll close it. Thank you.
Trying to close it up, so we have a force going out and a force coming in. You're a little too close, Sam. Yeah.
なんとかかわせたようですね。撃ちます。
They say this, but knowing full well, we will kill them.
Hyper Beam Saber!
I dare you to move! About that large beam saber. Cheating after using effect. This is how you use an effect.
Mudanamo
shirts in the history of all anime!
よく観念したらどうだ。
さすがにできるな。 ここからでは反撃できん。
I think that's all I can actually get from all the unlocks that I really want to have on my person. More enemies detected. Looks like they're talking to us this time.
Gato!
Those must be the newest mobile suits from Neo Zeon!
We're close to Grips. We must block their advance and make our way through.
That's the GP-02. Be extremely wary if it's Bazooka.
We already know what it's capable of doing.
Yep, can't forget that little firework.
All units, commence attack! Karius,
take some units and head towards Grips 2.
Roger. Gata!
lucky, was it? How many times do you intend to stand in my way?
As many times as it takes. I'll keep following you until I stop you.
Very well, Bumble Bell. You are our final obstacle. You are the wall we must overcome to realize the ideals of Zeon and claim true independence for the Spacenoids. Their reinforcements are approaching. We must end this quickly. Face me, Gato!
Bitches, please.
こちらのスピードにはついてこれまい。
Get some levels.
I'll hit you with the pin here.
Points. Does that look like a fluke to you? Strength because I did quite a bit of recording earlier. Some Secret of Mana 2018. Really? know what this means, guys.
Nobody.
What a coincidence. Now I feel very good.
Thank you.
Ewok device. Range, baby, range.
Charge 完了, 行けるぞ!
Hadouken!
Wait!
power goes up. What? That's it? Hit you with thy pimp hand. Guarantee.
この戦い負けられないんだ。できるな。射程距離外からだと意外とセコイ手を使うやつだ。
So do you。 If he dies, he dies.
まるでこっちの動きを読んでいるようだぞ。ここからでは反撃できん。
Thy pimp hand! If you can't hit me, then why bother?
てたようだな。
黒い三年生の力、この程度ではない。こいつ
launch a jet stream attack on that mobile suit. Marius, I'll take it.
See, now I can't get that out of my mind now. Been playing Dynasty Warriors Gundam far too long, and that line is always popping my head.
Mash Ortega! Launch a jet stream attack on that mobile suit!
これでどうだ。
当たるわけにはいかないのです。出てこなければ。
Dead. Oh, come on, really? Aina, really? Aina, girl, what is wrong with you?
ジオンの連中も無駄玉は打たん。なんの、なんなのだ。
バカめ、どこを狙っている。 Yes, we did. Yes, we did.
What you gotta say. Cause it's over. Believe it or not, you're dead. Nothing special, sir. Just get it. This hand of mine is burning red! Allow war to the grass victory! Gold Finger! It! It! End! Motherfucker, I am Domon Costume! No way! How could Lionel Bill be so powerful?
Ina, go on back. This is the reason why I don't pick you that much. Hit you with the paper. I like the enforcement's approaching. Dragoons.
Yay! Perfect timing!
This is Captain Bright Noah, the 13th Autonomous Corps, Londo Bell. We request that you head toward Grips 2 and provide support to... Hold on, Bright.
What the hell just happened?
Nobody attacked them. Were they that damaged that they just exploded?
No, as far as I can tell, they were basically undamaged. There's one thing I noticed that bothers me a lot. The explosion came from the cockpit.
You mean they all exploded from the inside?
That was totally awesome!
Compared! I get it now, that was your work, wasn't it, Butcher?
I never get tired of watching my human bombs go off. You're so beautiful to help with being cute to my eye.
Human bombs? No way, you mean, you don't mean...
The name is Little, the humans and the explode. My best wizard, I say so myself.
How could you do this, you monster?
I'm being you, and I make a little babies cry. You've no right to complain. Your vengeance is your shit.
What are you talking about? Don't listen to him. He's deranged.
I won't waste my time with you. You're too dumb to get in. You guys, come on over!
Look!
Shadow Mirror! And the way they appeared, that was a transition! Those are Shadow Mirror units. Does that mean they are allies?
Kill those Londo Bell magic!
Hold it! I'd like you to answer my question first. You said our existence is a sin. Does that mean that your purpose is to eliminate us?
You got it! That is a noble mission given to me by the Geyser!
If that is the case, why are you assisting Shadow Mirror? They aim to bring eternal chaos to our world. Does this not make him pity?
Yeah, admit it. You just like to kill people. Noble mission, my ass.
See, I knew you would do. It's your jizzers that can see it. Answer them, Mrs. Shane. We're old for the trip.
Looks like he has his own definition of what's good and what's evil.
You really think you're in the right, Butcher? Well, Newsflash, you're just a nut job! Screw you!
And that only means one thing. Death came to Helga. What? You know what? Let the Gundams have their fun. Fuck that shit.
ただのビームライフルだと思うな! この隙を見逃すわけにはいかんのでな。ジオンの亡霊どもめ。
Beam calling acquired. Lasers. Mayo, you've been holding us back, huh? Oh!
Hyper beam cyber?
Oh. 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 Oh
するのか。
ジオンの亡霊どもめ。
何だと？バカな。
No more black tri-stars.Two levels and a psycho friend.
Impossible! I'm one of the black tri-stars! Mayus Ortega, forgive me!
Trying to hit me when I don't want to be hit.
Choose a Kuga!
命に変えても。
なんとかかわせたようですね。直撃させます。
中破か。
No good.
我らは与えられた任務を果たすのみ。
緊急開始。直撃させます。 攻撃を開始します。艦長、グラビティブラストいけます。
思う存分やっちゃって。
グラビティブラスト発射します。
攻撃パターン選択終了。
I think after I'm done with this, I might do Project Crosszone after this. All right, there, Endless Frontier Exceed. Well, it's going in play, we still have to protect Ripsu. Proudly representing the OAMS team. Now we're ready to counterattack. This is our counterattack squadron.
我々の真実の戦いを後の世に伝えるために。
I guess you're not gonna hit me now. Big bitch. I do believe I will double up on that.
その時になろうと。
Sir, since you aimed at me, do you realize that this hand of mine glows with unawesome power? As Loud Roar tells me to grasp victory.
私の前に出てくるとは迂闊だったな。奴のデータを修正せねばならんな。敵は倒す。
Oh, I do believe I know what time it is. It is time for Code Kitty. If only I had that in New Gundam Breaker. I will put that on my Gunpla in a heartbeat. Anything that just screams, yeah, you is dead from the get-go. Mm-hmm. I would just go for it, just for on jump. You're gonna taste it and you're gonna like it!
Soria-chan, soko de charge! Itte koi!
Osamete iru?
Thank you.
3-6. Get that shit out of here. Point blank, mega
be. Gato!
You proved. But I won't be defeated by those who cannot understand our great cause.
The reason for this battle! I know exactly the reason. You and I are both fighting for what we believe in. It's just that we both believe in different things.
Well said.
Then there is only one thing to do. Settle once for all whose beliefs are right!
Blow your junk straight off. Like, no, boom. A plus one acquired.
This isn't getting us anywhere. But don't think I've given up yet.
Where are you going, Gato?
I won't forget this humiliation. I shall be waiting on the final battlefield!
What?
He retreated.
Final
Get your fucking old stupid ass ain't gonna do that shit again. Thank you. Silver Cowboy's the best kill. Like he wants to counter up that way. Come on. Back to normal music now. Oh, thank goodness. Getting sick and tired of that. Oh, so critical, acclaimed music.
ってもらう。そこだ。電波砲弾。
ソニック。ブーム。
禁物ということか。
ただのビームライフルだと思うな。
15 at one. Really? Right there? Imagine if Macross was in here. Ooh, it'd be all sorts of. I'm just chunking your ass straight now.
ならば。
Hibarika ass robo. Zeal. Nice. And a chunk of Super Alloy Z.
How could these evil creatures be so strong? How is he still alive? He should be dead! Look at his body, Cuphead! He's a cyborg. No, a robot!
Double numbers. Maybe that's how Vindel got him to do his bidding.
Don't be upset. I only obey the great god of Kaizok. Yeah, whatever. Let's finish him off. That would be a mistake. I will die soon either way. There is one thing I would like to ask you before my time comes. What now? I want to know why. For what purpose did you fight against me?
What kind of question is that? You wanted to defeat the evil bringing chaos to our world.
And who exactly asked you to do that?
We don't need to wait for someone to ask. That's just the right thing to do.
Why are you asking these questions?
Keep your composure, Captain Mizumaru.
Do you think that someone will thank you for that? Do you think that the people of Earth will be grateful? That they will be happy?
As the people of America.
Shut up! Stop trying to confuse us!
Earth's the planet we were born on, that's where we grew up. We won't let anyone destroy it, that's all there is to it. We're not doing it for a reward. We're just fighting to uphold our personal justice.
Justice. There's many interpretations of justice as our stars in the universe. And yet, that's what you chose to cling to in order to bring peace to the universe. Fools. You're nothing but fools.
Whoops. Turns up a lot of people think the same thing. I know that works, huh?
That's why Super is killed.
Then what would be the solution?
Chaos. That's the only way to satisfy every individual just at the same time.
I get it. I understand what it is that you guys are speaking. The true nature of this evil mind.
Took you long enough. It's too late now. You'll get me an ill, destined to be destroyed.
What do you mean? What's this evil mind?
I
like I get it too, but I'll never accept it. If I did, I...
Listen up, guys. We just beat the heck out of a very tough enemy, but this battle isn't over yet. Don't lose your focus. Defeat the remaining enemy forces. Charge! But, Captain, I don't think they're feeling so... Zip it, Megumi! I know what I'm doing. Come on, guys, we've got work to do.
She's right, Kope. They haven't conquered Grips 2 yet.
Yeah.
Thank you, Captain Mitsumoto.
They were laughing. We let ourselves accept what he said. We'd all lose our will to fight.
In a later installment, they did. Through another Tomino anime series that was once failed, but it succeeded in what it did. That series is called Densetsu Kyojin Ideon, or Space Runaway Ideon.
So I put on a brave face, just like you taught me. It's hard to feel motivated now.
I guess that guy really hit the nail on it right on the head. Eh?
Other guys said and said God was hard. But even so, I don't think he was right.
You have to admit that it's for those who fight for themselves who are strongest.
Are you saying that we'll never defeat Miozano, Shadowmere?
All these talks, fighting for the sake of the universe and its people, give me heartburn. To be honest, the world Shadowmere wants to make doesn't sound so bad.
Say whatever you want, call me selfish if you want to. But I will still fight while believing in my own sense of justice.
Amen, Akito. Amen.
Akito? Kenkawa.
You guys agree with me, right? We can't let them create a world of eternal conflict. That can't be the solution.
Meanwhile at Axis.
The nightmare of Solomon was nothing but a change in me. This wouldn't have happened if had I been there. Please forgive me, Lady Hawk. Enough. I've always known what I was. Enough. I've always known that I would have to face them directly. This result was inevitable. As you say, Mom Kai.
Then Damaza and Shadowman.
I happen to overhear your conversation. I have a proposal you may find interesting if you are willing to cooperate.
Let's go.
Shadowman, I don't know what you're planning, but I hope for your sake that this will be to be beneficial to my Lady Haman.
That will be for her to decide. I am in possession of a certain device that is just one step from your suit. That step being, if tested, I'm sure you would find it very useful. You will give me a complete explanation of that.
My lady, you mustn't fall for his honeyed words.
There cannot be any harm in learning more about it. Besides, I do not believe him to be the kind of man who would speak without being confident in his own words. As expected from Haman Khan, true leader of Neo Geo,
had you existed in my own world, I might not have needed to come here at all. I've no time for such nonsense. Now talk. I want a detailed explanation. I am not yet able to find it. Come down, Buddha. Judha Ashita. And now, Vindal Maza. I must be destined to meet the most peculiar woman. Meanwhile, back at our archive. Hey, did you guys hear? I did, they can't be right, can it? Would you guys keep it down? We're working here. This isn't the time for that. Some bitch going on. I didn't know, but I think we were dreaming. Could it be just a dummy balloon? Nah, it's too big. What about holographic projection? No, that's clearly a physical object. Have you heard about speed? Yes, almost unbelievable. Could this be the result of their newest technology? If it is, it's some impressive tech. Let someone tell us what's going on. We've been here working on your robots. Quit skirting around and say it like it is. He's right, Domon. What's happening? Zeon's fortress. What was it called again? Axis. That massive asteroid suddenly appeared near Krypton's tomb. Yeah. That's happening. That is totally happening. And we're gonna deal with that next time on Super Robot Tyson A Portable. So stay tuned in the next part when we deal. Episode 37. Thanks for sticking around, and I'll see you in the next part. Thanks so much for watching.